The average person will spend about $1,000 this holiday season on gifts, traveling, decorations, and cooking. Well, this morning, we've got some money-saving tips to help us stay within our budget this December. We've got Kathy Roser. She's Managing Director and Wealth Advisor with Morgan Stanley. Good morning and welcome.
Good morning. Great to be here.
Thanks for being here. This is an important topic because it really feels like we're just swiping our credit cards nonstop this holiday season.
Right, and that's really why it's important to have a plan. And the plan really starts with you writing down, that's the key, who you need to buy gifts for and what you need to spend on those people, and back it into the number that you want to spend. You talk about credit cards. If you're not really good at staying on budget, then use your debit card. The last thing you want to have happening is January rolling in and you've spent too much and you're behind the eight ball and getting ready for 2018.
Yeah, it's not a good feeling.
No, it's not. It adds stress.
Yes, it does. It certainly does. All right, so you got some tips to help us keep from overspending. The first one, you're saying have a plan and make a list for a limit. You know, no one likes the B word. We don't like the budget word. We don't like, what if some of those things come up, or that's the time that you want to give and you want to give so much to your kids?
You do, and I think there's a tendency that people want to have what other people have, and you really want to help people feel good about themselves, and so you want to give them really nice gifts. But there's, I use the internet. You go on the internet and you can find ways to stay within budget and find really great gifts so you're not tempted when you show up in the store to overspend.
Okay, second tip, don't procrastinate.
Well, I always think about if you procrastinate, you add more stress. So be proactive. You've got, we were just talking about this, 20 more days until the holidays and the day you need to have your Christmas presents. And so just get that plan together and don't wait till the last minute. You end up spending more money.
Yeah, you probably have to. This is something you should probably plan out a few months in advance, because I'm thinking the iPhone 10, one of the hottest gifts, it's $1,000.
Yeah, so
get
that budget.
Speaking of $1,000, a tip, don't buy what you can't afford.
Well, that's the tempting part, is this, to go over budget. And just think about the holidays. It's not really about how much money you spend. It's the thought that goes into the gift. And so when you compare yourself to others, just back off of that and remove the stress and just think about something that really would be nice to make that person feel good.
Okay, and you're reminding us to think outside the box as well. I think this is probably a good tip, because if you get creative, that could save you some money.
Actually, I think it's really pretty exciting when you think outside the box. So maybe you have that person that has everything that they could possibly need. Mm-hmm. And so you could think about something that's important to them and give something to charity. You could also think about that person that might be heading off to college, and you can think about giving money towards their 529 plan. Now, I know it's not that exciting when they open a present that says, I've given
it
money for the future.
Years later.
Or maybe somebody else who's graduated and has got a lot of debt. Help them pay off that debt.
Hey, you got that right. All right. Thank you so much, Kathy. We
Thank
appreciate
you.
It. For more info, log on to morganstanley.com.